Good evening, all of those of you who are joining us on site and online. It is good to have you with us on this Christmas Eve. If you are joining us online and have not already downloaded our bulletin, it can be found on the News and Upcoming Events page under the Calendars tab of our website, www.gracelutheranchesapeake.org. Let us prepare our hearts and minds for worship this night by listening to our prelude. Please stand as you are able and join with me in singing our gathering hymn, O Come All Ye Faithful, which is hymn 283 in the Evangelical Lutheran Worship Hymnal.
Oh, come, let us adore him, Christ. adore him. Oh, come, let us adore him. Oh, come, let us adore in Christ the Lord. Yea, Lord, we greet thee on this happy morning. Jesus, to thee be all glory given. Word of the Father, now in flesh appearing. Oh, come, let us adore him. Oh, come, let us adore him. Oh, come, let us adore him, Christ the Lord.
The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness has not overcome it. Those who dwelt in the land of deep darkness, on them light has shined. We have beheld Christ's glory, glory as of the only Son from the Father. For to us a child is born, to us a son is given. In him was life, and the life was the light of all people. May the grace and truth of Christ be with you. Let us pray. Almighty God, you made this holy night shine with the brightness of the true light. Grant that here on earth we may walk in the light of Jesus' presence, and in the last day wake to the brightness of his glory. Through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. You may be seated for our readings.
A reading from Isaiah. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Those who lived in a land of deep darkness, on them light has shined. You have multiplied the nation. You have increased its joy. They rejoice before you as with joy at the harvest, as people exult when dividing plunder. For the yoke of their burden and the bar across their shoulders, the rod of their oppressor, you have broken as on the day of Midian. For all the boots of the trampling soldiers and all the garments rolled in blood shall be burned as fuel for fire. For a child has been born for us, a son given to us. Authority rests upon his shoulders, and he is named Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. His authority shall grow continually, and there shall be endless peace for the throne of David and his kingdom. He will establish and uphold it with justice and with righteousness from the time onward and forevermore. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Let us sing Psalms 96 responsively by verse as translated in the Evangelical Lutheran Worship Hymnal. Sing to the Lord a new song. Sing to the Lord,
all the earth. Sing to the Lord, bless the name of the Lord. Proclaim God's salvation from day to day. Declare God's glory among the nations and God's wonders among the peoples. For great is the Lord, and greatly to be praised, more to be feared than all gods. As for all the gods of the nations, They are but idols, but you, O Lord, have made the heavens. Majesty and magnificence are in your presence. Power and splendor are in your sanctuary. Ascribe to the Lord, you families of the peoples. Ascribe to the Lord honor and power. Ascribe to the Lord the honor due the holy name. Bring offerings and enter the courts of the Lord. Worship the Lord in the beauty of holiness. Tremble before the Lord, all the earth. Tell it out among the nations, the Lord is King, the one who made the world so firm that it cannot be moved will judge the peoples with equity. Let the heavens rejoice and let the earth be glad. Let the sea thunder and all that is in it. Let the field be joyful in all that is therein. Then shall all the trees of the wood shout for joy at your coming, the Lord. For you come to judge the earth. You will judge the world with righteousness and the peoples with your truth.
A reading from Titus. The grace of God has appeared, bringing salvation to all, training us to renounce impurity, impurity and worldly possessions, and in the present age to live lives that are self-controlled, upright, and godly, while we wait for the blessed hope and the manifestation of the glory of our great God and Savior, Jesus Christ. He it is who gave himself for us, that we might redeem us from all iniquity and purity. For himself, a people of his own, who are zealous for all good deeds. Word of life, word of God. Thanks be to God.
Alleluia, Lord, to whom shall we go? Have the words of eternal life. Alleluia.
The Holy Gospel according to Luke. Glory to you, O Lord. In those days, a decree went out from Emperor Augustus that all the world should be registered. This was the first registration and was taken while Quirinius was governor of Syria. All went to their own towns to be registered. Joseph also went from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to the city of David called Bethlehem, because he was descended from the house and family of David. He went to be registered with Mary, to whom he was engaged and who was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for her to deliver her child, and she gave birth to her firstborn son and wrapped him in bands of cloth and laid him in a manger, because there was no place for them in the inn. In that region, there were shepherds living in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. But an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing you good news of great joy for all the people. To you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign for you. You will find a child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in a manger." And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host praising God and saying, glory to God in the highest heaven and on earth, peace among those whom he favors. When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, let us go now to Bethlehem and see this thing that has taken place, which the Lord has made known to us. So they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the child lying in the manger. When they saw this, they made known what had been told them about this child, and all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds had told them. But Mary treasured all these words and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen as it had been told them. The Gospel of our Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. I invite you to be seated. Let us pray. Let the words of my mouth and the meditations of our hearts be acceptable in your sight, O Lord, our strength and our Redeemer. Amen. Earlier this week, the Department of Housing and Urban Development released their annual homelessness assessment report. The report found that 582,462 people were experiencing homelessness on a single night in January of 2022. 582,462. Thankfully, that's only a slight increase over the number from 2020. And thinking about what has happened financially between then and now, that is reason for celebration, that only 0.3% increase. It's true that more people than ever have been moved out of homelessness in the U.S., just over 900,000 a year on average since 2017 have moved out of homelessness. But the problem is that about the same number or more have lost housing in the past few years. So there's this big turnover, but the whole number has remained pretty stable. We seem to be pretty good at providing services to those who are currently experiencing housing insecurity to get them back into stable housing. But we don't seem to be so good at the preventing of homelessness. Having this report come out and hearing these stats in the news got me thinking about the nativity story this week. There's actually quite a bit of homelessness in the story. Joseph and Mary, although maybe not by our traditional definition homeless, they are away from home and cannot find a traditional place to stay. At least for that night, their housing was insecure. And then there are the shepherds, who did not live in town with everybody else, but lived in the fields with their flocks. Most likely they probably had made shelters in the caves that surrounded their fields. But they were not welcome to enter the city just like anybody else. So there's some amount of insecurity in their housing as well. And then the Epiphany story, that when we commemorate the Magi, the wise men, who left their homes to seek out Jesus. They had more means to find housing along their way, to find secure shelter, but they too were away from home. And there tends to be a lot of homelessness in this time of year as well, now, here, today. In addition to the traditional definition of homelessness that surrounds us, all of those in our community that just don't have secure housing, there's other ways that people might experience homelessness during the holidays. Immigrants or refugees or those of members of our armed services that are deployed, that are away from their home, from their community or their country. Although always true throughout the year might feel more palpable during the holiday season. And even those who return to the home that they grew up in might not be a safe place for their mental health. When they go home to visit, it might not feel like home. Or those who have been estranged from their families and cannot return home to spend the holiday with their loved ones. I think too of those who have experienced the death of a loved one, that again, it can feel more palpable during this time of year. For where that saying, the home is where the heart is, if you don't have that connection, even if you have a roof over your head, you might feel a little homeless. All of these ways of being homeless can feel like deep valleys, or like everything is covered with a thick cloud of despair. But the good news that was foretold in Isaiah and that is manifested in Jesus is that God is bigger and brighter than all of those pits and shadows. But as some of you might remember from my Advent sermons of years past, we do not just commemorate the historical coming of Jesus during this season of the year. This is not a once and done promise from God, but an ongoing one as we remember the history of Jesus' birth and anticipate the majesty of Jesus coming again, but also are invited to experience the mystery of Jesus present among us here and now. That mystery of the promise being fulfilled of God's presence with us. Thankfully, no one of us has to do all of the Jesus work, all of the fixing and healing and homing. That's Jesus' job, to take on the whole of that. But we together, as the body of Christ, we can be part of Jesus' work. It is Jesus who is the wonderful counselor. But some of us, members of the body of Christ, are called to be counselors, therapists, social workers, and be about God's work of healing past hurts that hold us back, and ensure wraparound services for those in need. Jesus is the mighty God, but some of us, members of the body of Christ, can use our might to physically make a difference in the world, whether that's hauling food from the food bank here to Grace and distributing it to those in need, or collecting toys and delivering to those who otherwise would have no presents for the year. Jesus is the everlasting Father, but some of us are called to be mentors, teachers, role models, parental figures of God's love, to embody that love of God for children throughout our community. Jesus is the Prince of Peace, but we all can wage peace with our time, talents, and treasures, with our votes and voices and purchases. It is Jesus' role to save us, but we, the body of Christ, are the ones who God works through. It is our hands, our voices, our hearts that God is made manifest in right here and right now. For God is truly with us in the good and the bad. When we feel like we are without home, whether that be safe place, shelter, or connection, and as we work to end all that leads to others being housing insecure, being homeless, whether that's literal or figurative. So although we remember this night an event long past and long for a day yet to come, we can also rest assured in the blessed hope that God is made manifest here in and now, that God is Emmanuel, God with us. Jesus, the wonderful counselor, mighty God, everlasting Father, Prince of Peace, our Lord and Savior, is the gift we all receive and can share with one another. Amen. I invite you to stand as you are able and join with me in our hymn of the day, Hark the Herald Angels Sing. It's hymn 270 from the Evangelical Lutheran Worship Hymnal.
Hark the herald angels sing, glory to the new. Joyful are you, nations rise, join the triumph of the skies. With angelic hosts proclaim, Christ is born in Bethlehem. Hark, the herald angels sing, glory to the newborn King. Christ by high adored, Christ the everlasting Lord, late in time behold him come, offspring of a virgin's womb, veiled in flesh the Godhead see, hail incarnate deity, pleased as man with us to dwell, Jesus our
with the whole church. Let us confess our faith with the words of the Nicene Creed. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen.
We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, was incarnate of the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary, and became truly human. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again, in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is worshiped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. With wonder and thanksgiving for Christ coming into the world, we pray for the church, the life of the earth, and the whole human family. Your infinite love is born to us this night. With choirs of angels, the church proclaims the good news. Send us out as messengers of the hope that has come to all people. God of grace, hear our prayer. You are pleased to dwell with your creatures, and the whole earth sings for joy. Renew the splendor of creation from the smallest cell to the widest galaxies. Guide us to be wise stewards of your gifts for the sake of generations to come. God of grace, hear our prayer. Your authority is over the nations. Break the rod of oppression in every land and free all people from fear. Bring peace where there is war, compassion where there is suffering, and healing where there is disease. God of grace, hear our prayer. Your loving kindness embraces everyone in need. Help any for whom this season is lonely or joyless. Comfort those among us or known to us who are experiencing distress of body or mind, missing loved ones, or grieving, especially those listed on our prayer list and those we name aloud or silently. God of grace, hear our prayer. You welcome those who have died into the joyous light of glory. We give thanks for the saints of every time and place who have praised you with lives of faith and humility. Inspire us by their example to love you by serving others. God of grace, hear our prayer.
Pondering the mystery of eternal love made flesh in Christ Jesus, we commend all for whom we pray to the mercy of God. Amen. Amen. The peace of Christ be with you always. Let us share a sign of that peace with one another, both with those you are physically gathered with and across the Zoom platform. Feel free to use the chat or unmute to share the peace. Thank you. As we do each time we gather for worship, we remember that all that we have, our time, talents, and treasures, are gifts from God. And we can use those gifts throughout the year to do God's work in the world, to do things like combat homelessness. There are many ways that we do that here at Grace, that we strive to be servants to all people, and all financial gifts given to Grace are used towards that end. We are thankful for all of you who partner with us to do that work. There's information in the bulletin and on our website about how to make a financial gift electronically. And there's also our address if you prefer to send a check. But keeping all of the gifts in mind, financial and not, that come together as the body of Christ to do God's work, we pray our offering prayer.
Let us pray. God of abundance, receive and bless these gifts we have offered. Join our hearts with the song of the angels and gather us at your table of celebration. Strengthen us to share with all the world the abundance of your grace upon grace, poured out in Jesus Christ, the Word made flesh. Amen.
Please stand as you are able.
The Lord be with you.
And also.
The beginning and the end, the giver of life. Blessed are you for the birth of creation. Blessed are you in the darkness and in the light. Blessed are you for your promise to your people. Blessed are you in the prophet's hopes and dreams. Blessed are you for Mary's openness to your will. Blessed are you for your son, Jesus, the Word made flesh. In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread, gave thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body, given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." Together, let us proclaim the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. With this bread and cup, we remember your word dwelling among us, full of grace and truth. We remember our new birth in his death and resurrection, and we look with hope for his coming. Come, Lord Jesus. Holy God, we long for your spirit. Come among us. Bless this meal. May your word take flesh in us. Awaken your people. Fill us with your light. And bring the gift of peace on earth. Come, Holy Spirit. All praise and glory are yours, Holy One of Israel, Word of God incarnate, Power of the Most High, one God, now and forever. Amen. Gathered into one by the Holy Spirit, let us pray as Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Glory to God in the highest. Come to the table of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world. Grant us peace. Grant us peace.
For those of you who will be communing in your homes or from your pews, hear these words of promise: the body of Christ given for you, the blood of Christ shed for you.
Body of Christ given for you, the 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 body of Christ given for you.
Crib for a bed, the little Lord Jesus laid down his sweet head. The stars in the bright sky looked down where he lay. The little Lord Jesus asleep on the hay. The cattle are lowing, the baby awakes, but little Lord Jesus, no crying he makes. I love you, Lord Jesus, look down from the sky and stay by my cradle till morning is nigh. I ask you to stay close by me forever and love me, I pray. Bless all the dear children in your tender care and
Please stand in body or spirit. The body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ strengthen you and keep you in his grace. Amen.
Let us pray. God, our Redeemer, you have fed us at this table with gifts of grace, truth, and life. As you have gathered us in joy, send us forth as messengers of your peace. Make us shine with the good news of your glory, born to us in Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen.
Let us join in singing hymn 281, Silent Night, Holy Night. And as we do, we will pass the light of Christ symbolically through the space. If you are joining us online and have a candle handy, feel free to light it at this time.
Silence, night, holy night, all is calm, all is bright, round yon virgin mother and child, holy infant so tender and mild, sleep in heavenly silence, night, holy night, shepherds quake at the sight, glory stream from heaven afar, heavenly hosts sing alleluia, Christ the Savior is born, Christ the Savior is born. Silent night, holy night, Son of God, love's pure light, radiant beams from your holy face, with the dawn of redeeming grace, Jesus Lord at your birth, Jesus Lord at your
God bless you and keep you. Jesus, grant you grace and truth, and the Spirit send peace upon your hearts, now and forever. Amen. Amen. Let us sing Joy to the World, hymn 267 in the Evangelical Lutheran Worship Hymnal.
Joy to the world, the Lord is come. Let earth receive her King. Let every heart prepare him room. And heaven and nature sing, and heaven and nature sing, and heaven and heaven and nature sing. Joy to the earth, the Savior reigns. Let all their songs employ fields and floods, rocks, hills, and plains. Repeat the sounding joy, repeat the sounding joy, repeat, repeat the sounding joy. No more let sin and sorrow grow, nor thorns infest the ground. He comes to make his blessings known. For as the church is found, for as the curse is found, and wonders of his love, and wonders of his love, and wonders, wonders of his love.
Christ the Savior is born. Go in peace. Proclaim this good news. Thanks be to God.
Merry Christmas. Join us tomorrow morning on site or online at 9:45 for Christmas Day worship.